فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. This is the second day of the Dawra, which we named ضبط العلم, precision in knowledge. We've previously taken other books. We've also started the first part of this kitab, and we finished the first part, which was تعريف الكلام وبيان أقسامه وعلامة كل قسم. So we talked about the definition of speech. We spoke about the types of speeches there are and the signs of each one. We have now got 8 different chapters to go through. 8. So what our plan, inshaAllah ta'ala, is these 8 chapters that remains. Today we're going to take 4 of them. And then tomorrow we're going to take the last 4 bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. So today, inshaAllah ta'ala, we're going to have to take Babul I'rab. Second, inshaAllah ta'ala, that we're going to take is Babu Ma'rifati Alamati al-I'rab. The fourth, Babul Af'al. The fourth Bab, meaning after, with Kalam added onto it. So it's all 9 together. And Babu Marfu'at al-Asma. Today we're going to do those 4, inshaAllah, which is Babu al-I'rab, Babu Ma'rifati Alamati al-I'rab. Third one we're going to be doing, inshaAllah ta'ala, is Babu al-Af'al. And the fourth is Babu Marfu'at al-Asma. And then we have 4 more remaining, inshaAllah ta'ala, which is then going to be Babu Mansubat al-Asma, Bab Makhfudat al-Asma, and then we'll do the 4 tawabi'. And last but not least, we will do Ma'rifa al-Nakira, which is the 4 that we're going to be doing. So today I think is going to be very, very solid, inshaAllah ta'ala. I will simplify it, but I want students to focus with me. I'll be speaking a bit faster, and as you can all see, my voice has come back, alhamdulillah. We have till 1 o'clock today, so every minute counts.
باب الإعراب. الإعراب هو التقدير ورفع الكلمة لاختلاف العوامل التهديمية عليها نقضاً وتقديراً.
The author started باب الإعراب by defining what إعراب means. That's how he started it. إعراب linguistically means, or lexically, it means الإظهار والبيان. It is to make something apparent, and it's to clarify something. That's why the Arabs, they say, أعربت عما في نفسي. I made apparent what was inside me. I brought it out. Okay, that's what it, in the lexical meaning, or that's what it means in its linguistic usage. But according to the grammarians, what they see إعراب as is هو تغيير أواخر الكلمة لاختلاف العوامل الداخلة عليها لفظا أو تقديرا. They see it as تغيير, changing, that occurs to the last part of the wording. And why does it? لاختلاف العوامل. The agents and the factors in which it enters onto are causing it to change. And the way that the changing occurs is in 2 ways, as the author mentions, لفظا أو تقديرا. لفظاً أو تقديراً. It changes explicitly and it also changes implicitly. So it's explicit and it's implicit. Explicit means it's clear, you can see the changing, and you can. It also changes تقديراً, which is implicit. So let me give you an example. We take, for example, let's take the word زيد, for example. Let's focus on the word زيد, the name زيد. We say جاء زيد. زيد came. So you say جاء زيد. زيد here is what? It's مرفوع. دن. I will talk about what مرفوع means, inshallah ta'ala. Then you say رأيت زيدا. رأيت زيدا. Now Zaydan has now become mansub. And then you say marartu bi Zaydin. Zayd has now become majroor. Zayd has changed in all of the three different sentences I gave you. And the changing is explicit in the sense you can all see it. It's lafdan. You can see ja'a Zaydun, you can see the changes. My mouth is closing and it's becoming like that. Ra'aytu Zaydan, my mouth is becoming dan. Marartu bi Zaydin, and it's becoming din. All three times the changing is explicit, zahir, you can see it. Okay, brothers? Let's change Zayd to Musa. Ja'a Musa. Ra'aytu Musa. Marartu bi Musa. Musa's changed, but is the changing explicit? Can you see it? It's implicit. It's an implicit changing. It's a changing that is not apparent. So that's what the author means. Why has it changed? So we know now how it changes, or the how the changing occurs, but why is it changing? Each time, اختلاف العوامل, the agents and the factors that are causing it to change are different. Or it's in different contexts, and due to different contexts that it's in, it's changing. The first time I said, جَاءَ زَيْدٌ, Zayd here is a subject. رَأَيْتُ زَيْدًا, Zayd here is an object. مَرَرْتُ بِزَيْدٍ, Zayd here has fallen after the harfu jar, which is ba. Each time, the things that are causing it to change are different. That's what the author means. And where is it changing from? It's changing from the ending. So I'rab observes how many things, brothers? Pay attention. Write this down, it's important. I'rab is it's about changing. It's about what? Changing. Brothers, pay attention here. I'rab is about what? Changing. One. Second point is about it's where does the changing happen? And it happens at the ending of the wording. So the changing occurs at the ending of the wording. That's the second point. This is grammar. This is nahu. It's not about the middle changing, and it's not about the front changing. It's about the what? The ending changing. Third, brothers, pay attention to this. The third one is factors are different. لِاخْتِلَافِ الْعَوَامِلِ. The factors that are causing it to change are differing. So there are awamin, something called amin. Amil are agents. Agents are causing it to change. That's the third point. Fourth one is how it changes. And that is imma lafdan aw taqdiran. Explicitly or implicitly. Then i'rab are those four points that you need to keep in mind. Have you guys all understood what i'rab means? I'm now going to move on to a very important point that I mentioned yesterday. Before we go to babu ma'rifat al-alamat al-i'rab, before we go into it, we need to talk about this point, which is very, very important. When I categorized yesterday the noun, and when I also categorized the verb, and I categorized the particle, the harf, so I divided the asma to two, and I also divided the verbs into two, and I also divided the what? The harf into two, right? Each one two. Sorry, three, Sahullah. Three. It's early morning. Three. Sorry, I divide each one into three, right? Asma are three. The af'al are three. The huruf are three. They are all what? Three. So let's look at how much did we categorize the noun into? Mubhar, mudmar, mubham. The af'al we divided into three. Madi, mudari', amar. The huruf we divided into three. مشترك بين الأسماء والأفعال مختص بالأسماء المختص بالأفعال. In إعراب حرف لا مجال له. It has no place. We don't talk about it. You will never see حرف being spoken about in chapters of إعراب. حروف are مبني. They're not معرب. So they're not spoken about. Get rid of them. We're left with now what? Asma and what? Af'al. We're left with Asma and Af'al. We're left with the nouns and we're now left with the verbs. Okay, pay attention here. The Asma, Let's repeat it one more time. How many types were they? Three. Mudhar, Mudhmar, and Mubham, right? The last two, which is Mudhmar and Mubham. So the Mudhmar are the three types of Dhamair, which is Al-Mutakallim, Al-Mukhatab, and Al-Ghaib. It doesn't enter the chapter of I'raab, all of them. So Mudhmar, eliminated in Bab al-I'raab. You will never talk about Dhamair because it's Mabni. Okay. What about Mubham? Mubham, we said it's two things. Ism Ishara and Asma al-Mawsoola. They're both Mabni. Eliminate them. They have no place in the I'raab. So from the Asma, we've only taken what? The first one, which is? Mudhar. Six come out from that. The Mudhar, it gave birth to six. From its womb came out six. The six are Ism Mufrad, Muthanna, three types of Jama'ah. Jama'u Dhakar Salim, Jama'u Mu'annath Salim, Jama'u Taksir, and Asma'ul Khamsa. One more time. Ism Mufrad, singular noun. See, the order I'm doing it is what allows me to remember it easily. I'm going from smallest to the highest. And at the end, I'm always just keeping Asma'ul Khamsa. Sah? So Mufrad is one. And then what, if you go up, what's next? Muthanna. And we go up, what is it? And then I know Jama'ah is already three. The Jama'ah three times. Always start with Mudhakkar Salim. I'm only joking. Jama'ah Mu'annath Salim. I don't get in trouble. Jama'ah Mu'annath Salim. Jama'ah Mudhakkar Salim. And Jama'ah Taksir are the three times. So how many children do we have in total? Don't worry, we're going to come to each one. We're going to see each one. Don't worry. Don't be too concerned here right now. Are you with me, brothers? And the sixth one is Asma'ul Khamsa. Those six come out from the womb of what? Ism Muhar. Now let's go to the Af'al now. Are you with me, brothers? Brothers, let's go to the Af'al. The Af'al, how many times did we say they were? Madi, Mudari' and Amar. The Mudari', put that on hold for us. Madi. Madi is always Mabni. Amar, always Mabni. The Mudari' is Mu'rab. Majority of the times, only twice does it become Mabni. إِذَا الْتَحَاقَ بِهِ نُونُ النِّسْوَةِ أو نُونُ التَّوْكِيدِ. If a fi'l Mudari' نُونُ التَّوْكِيدِ or نُونُ النِّسْوَة connects itself to at the ending of it, it becomes Mabni. Other than that, it's Mu'rab. So which one have we, what have we taken from the fi'l Mudari'? So which one, let me rephrase that question. What have we taken from the Af'al? Only the Mudari'. So the Mudari' and the Asma' we only took from it what? Mudhar. So we took only one from each. The Huruf, get rid of it. Pay attention now. The Fi'l al-Mudari' gave birth to two. Are you with me? Gave birth to two. The first one that came out of it is الفعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. It's the فعل المضارع that nothing connects to the ending of it. And the second one is أفعال الخمسة is what they call it. Is it correct to call it أفعال الخمسة? No. It's better to call it أمثلة الخمسة. There's a reason why. We're not going to speak about it here. Leave it for أفعال الخمسة. How much do we have in total now? The six that I mentioned before and how much? Two more. How much is total? We have those eight. Those eight are what I'raab is done on. Simple, right? What's the signs of I'raab? How much signs of I'raab are there? Four. You just need to know how when they go into those four places, each one, how do I deal with it? That's the crust and the crust of I'raab. And to Ma'i, are you with me, brothers? When we look at the four, we've got al-raf'u, wal-nasbu, wal-jarru, wal-jazmu. This is the order of ajrumiyya, right? Al-raf'u, wal-nasbu, wal-jarru. I'm a khafdu, he calls it. And then the last one is what? Jazm. Four, right? Remember, the first two, the asma' and the af'al share together. So full eight will go into each one. But when you come to al-jar, that's specific for the noun. So the only six are going to enter here. And the last one is what? Jazmu. Ism won't come into jazm. So get rid of the six. You're only going to start thinking of what? The two. That's what it is. That's the now what we're going to go into details. I've now just given you overview. So it might have gone over your head. Now we're going to go into details regarding that. Are you with me, brothers? Now, that information I gave you is what's going to take us another hour and a half to explain. That 5-10 minutes information is going to be an hour or even hour and a half or even more to go through each point regarding it now. But that's the khulas, it's the summary of it. Hey. The author now goes into أقسام الإعرابي. Some scholars would call it أنواع الإعرابي, the difference of wordings. And why, which one's correct? Should we call it أقسام or should we call it نوع? We'll speak about that in متميمة الأجوبة. These things, totally correcting and discussion and dialogue of wordings, we'll leave that to متميمة الأجوبة. أقسام الإعرابي, he called it. The أقسام الإعراب are two types. What he said are only two types. He categorized it into four, but we can actually categorize it into what? Into two. Pay attention. The first one is مُشْتَرَكٌ بَيْنَ الْإِسْمَاءِ وَالْأَفْعَالِ, shared between nouns and verbs. Signs that are shared between nouns and verbs. Are you with me, brothers? Signs that are shared between noun and verbs. And those are two that the author mentioned. What are they? What is it? الرَّفْعُ وَالنَّصْبُ. رَفْعَ and nasb are shared between the nouns and the verb. The second that the author mentioned is mukhtas. Mukhtas means specific, and he mentioned two of that. What is it? Specific to the nouns and specific to the verbs. What is specific to the nouns? Al-khafdu. What's specific to the verbs? Brothers? Al-jazmu. We finished that short point. Hey? The author now goes into علامات الرفع, the signs of رفع. We've just now got to know, we learned right now, the definition of إعراب. Are you with me, brothers? And how it shows. We also learned that changing happens. We spoke about the issue of how the changing happens. We've also spoken about there is something called I'rab and there's something called Bina. We spoke about that. We also spoke about the types of I'rab there is. We also spoke about that which is specific to nouns and that which is specific to verbs and that which is also shared between them in terms of signs. Are you with me? We're now going to go into the first of the four signs that the author mentioned. And the order is as follows. Al-Raf'u, wal-Nasbu, wal-Khafdu, wal-Jazm. We're going to do those four signs, inshallah ta'ala, in the next hour or so. Bi-Ibnillahi Kareem. The author starts with Raf'a. The author says, Alamatul Raf'i, the signs of Raf'a. Okay, so how many signs does I'rab have? For, what's the first one? Al-Raf'u. We're now going to discuss Al-Raf'u. We finished that one. We're going to go to the second one, Nasb. We're going to finish that one. We're going to go to the third one, which is Khaf. We finished that one. And then we're going to go to what? Al-Jazm. And we're going to finish that. And then we have finished Babu Ma'rifati Alamati Al-Arab. That's it. And that can be called the backbone of grammar. Okay? That is what you need to really understand. It's the trickiest, it is the most needed, it's the most serious part of it. Al-Raf'u. The author says, للرفع أربع علامات الضمة والواو والألف والنون. So we can divide the رفع into two. Categorize the رفع into how much? We'll divide it into two. The first one is alama, which is asliya, a original alama, a original sign. And always remember, until I tell you that it's not the case, but by default position, you always need to remember the alama, which is asliya, is always going to be a haraka. Okay? It can never be harf. Unless I tell you something else in a particular place. Okay? If I say this time it's not, then it's not. Which is going to happen, we're going to see soon, inshallah. But the asal, the default position, is that whenever I say to you this is the original sign, it means no one can ask you why it's this sign. So if we see something which is marfu'u bil dhamma, no one can ask you limada. Are you with me? But if something is marfu'u bil alifi, I can say to you limada. Because the alif is not laysa ala al-asl. And anything that leaves its default position and it leaves the original position, we have rights to ask you why. Sah brothers. That's why you always find marfu'un bil alif li'annahu. Sah? There has to be ta'leel, reasoning behind it. But when it is marfu'un bil dhammati, when it's marfu'un bil dhamma, you don't need to explain yourself. You're upon the original default position. So the author, rahimahullah, remember, we're dealing with what? The eighth that I mentioned. So we're just going to divide those eight in the rough four signs that the author has now given us. Does that make sense? The first one is Ad-Dhamma. So from the eight that you mentioned before, which is Ismul Mufrad, Muthanna, Jam'ul Mudhakkar Salim, Jam'ul Mu'annath Salim, Jam'ul Mudhakkar Salim, Jam'ul Taksir, Al-Asma' Al-Khamsa, Al-Fi'l Mudhari' Al-Ladhi Lam Yattasil Bi-Akhiri Shay, Fi'l Mudhari' Al-Ladhi Lam Yattasil Bi-Akhiri Shay, and Af'al Al-Khamsa. From the eight that you mentioned, which one of those enter into the Dhamma? It's the asal position. How much? Enter into it, four enter into it. Four are what enters into marfu'u bil Dhamma. Ama, the far'i, the asli version. Four enter it. What's the first one? Ism mufrad. Jam'u taksir. Jam'u mu'annath salim. الفعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. Those four are what enter into Dhamma. From the eight that I mentioned, four enter into Dhamma. The first one is the singular noun. Singular noun enters into the Dhamma. جمعو التكسير, which is the broken. Each one we're going to study. Don't worry. What are they? I don't know. We'll take them word for word. Okay? As soon as the author mentions them, and you don't need to. If you've got the matan with you, it's right in front of you. I'm just organizing for you. So in the Dhamma heading, how much enter there? Four. Ism Mufrad, Jam'u Taksir, Jam'u Mu'annath Salim, Al-Fi'l Mudari' Alladhi Lam Yattasil Bi-Akhirihi Shay. They all enter under Al-Raf'u, which under it is Al-Dhamma. Okay? Then the author mentions the second one, which is what? Al-Wawu. والالف والنون الواو and الالف النون all of them are فرعية all of them they fall under the heading of الفرعية. So we've divided the رفع into two. أصلي فرعي. أصلي means what? Original. فرعي means sub branch. So أصلي means the root, and then فرعي means sub branch. Under the فرعي, the other three that the author mentioned, which is الواو والالف والنون, they are all فرعي. What falls under alif? Al-Muthanna. What falls under waw? Jam'u al-Mudhakkar Salim al-Asma' al-Khamsa. What falls under noon? Af'al al-Khamsa. And the author mentions all of them for you. It's in the book. Hey. Now the author is going to mention them. Now the author is going to mention them. So you just need to organize them. Hey. So the author, what did he say? In the Dhamma, how many things are going to enter in the Dhamma? Four. And I already told you what the four were. Just underline them. Ism Mufrad, wa Jam'u Taksir, wa Jam'u Mu'annath Salim, wa Fi'l Mudhari' Alladhi Lam Yattasil Bi Akhiri Shay. Ha. These are the four that the author mentioned. So let's stand over each one. Now you guys need to know the eight, okay? Four are mentioned here. And the other four are in the what? Far'i. Four are in the asal and four are in the fara. The fara, we divided them into what? Three. Al-alifu, wal-waw, wal-noon. Alif is muthanna, waw is two. Which is what? Ta'amu dhakar salim, al-asma'u al-khamsa. And the noon is what? Af'alu al-khamsa. The author is going to mention each of the four. Pay attention now. What is ism mufrad? We need to know it. So when next time we see it, we know it properly. Ism mufrad is a singular noun. Definition wise, it's known as ma laysa muthannan, wa la majmu'an, wa la mulhaqan bihima. It is anything that's not dual. And it is also anything that is not plural. And it is also anything that is not given the ruling of any of them. There are words that are literally not dual, nor are they plural, but they are given the ruling of a dual or the ruling of a plural. What are those? We're going to come to them, inshallah ta'ala. Are you with me? It's basically, where does the muthanna come from? Muthanna always stems from a singular. We'll see that theme soon, inshallah. Are you with me? Zayd, Zayd, Zaydani, you say, right? Are you with me, brothers? Are we together? Zayd and Zayd, what do they make? Zaydani in Arabic, two Zayds. So it's two Zayds that came together that made Sahab brothers. Are you with me? That's a muthanna, that's a dual. Okay? The thing is here now is, if we find a word that's just dual, has never come from two singulars, this is called mulhaq min muthanna. It's found to just be like this. Are you with me? Does that make sense? We'll see examples of that in the Lan Kareem. So Ja'a Muhammadun, Muhammad came, wal-fata, and the boy came. Muhammad here is what? Ja'a is fi'lu madhi mabniun al-fati la mahala lahu min al-i'rab. Ja'a, that's what it is. Muhammadun is fa'ilu ja'a marfu'un wa alamatu rafihi dhammatun da'iratun ala akhiri. Wal-fata ma'atufun ala Muhammad. Huh? So what does it become? Marfu'un wa alamatu rafihi is what? Dhamma. Because it's a ma'atuf, it's connecting the atfa from the tawabi'. Pay attention here, like what concerns us here is that Muhammad is what? Muhammad is a singular noun. Fata is also a singular noun. We don't need to go into all the technical terms that you're saying. Right now, we just need to know that Muhammad is what? Is a singular noun. Fata is also a singular noun. Khalas. Are you with me? It says fata here is, it can't show. I told you that before. مقدم منع من ظهورها التعذر. That's what it is. The second one is جمع التكسير. The author mentions it here. جمع التكسير is it came from a singular. It turned into a plural. Okay, it turned into a plural. Are you with me, brothers? This plural though is broken. It broke how it was in its form. It broke now. For example, Hakim. Hakim. It's Ha, Alif, Kaf, Mim. Hakim. Sah? Make it plural. Hukam. What happened in the beginning? No, what happened to the first haraka? It was ha. You turned it to hu. What did you just do? You changed it. You changed the haraka. Hu. And when it was singular, what was it? Ha. Now you turned it to what? Hu. So you say, okay, what was after the ha when it was singular? Ha. Alif, right? When you made it plural, what was this? What was after the alif? What was after the ha? Hu. Ka. What came after it? A kaf. So in the singular, a alif came after the ha. In the plural, a kaf came after the ha. Are you with me, brothers? So the word is getting broken up. It's not coming saved and protected, and it's actually getting changed and distorted. That's what's called broken. The word is broken up. It breaks in six different ways. There are six different ways that the changing of the mufrad of the jam'u takseer happens. The first one is bishakli faqat.